In this clip, I will demonstrate the process of recording a sales order from a customer. From the Marketing and Sales module, we'll go to Orders and open a sales order form. From here, we'll press F6 and choose the customer from which we want to have a sales order. As we move down the fields, we can see that the date appears automatically, as well as the order number, which is according to the numeration template defined at the beginning of the year. There are a number of tabs which contain more information about the order. In the Price tab, we have the customer's currency, which is filled in automatically, although this can be changed. We also have the overall discount column in the event that there is a discount for this order. Let's move to the References tab. Here we can base the order on a price quotation or a blanket order. As a result, the order will be itemized automatically from these documents in the Order Items sublevel forms. In the Payment Information tab, we can change the tax code as well as the payment terms that appear according to the customer's default definitions. Press F1 on any column to display the help regarding that column. Now let's move to the sublevel form. We can go to the order items and see that the itemized parts are automatically populated from the price quote. All mandatory columns are emphasized as defined in the form's general view settings. For example, the part number, currency, and due date are all mandatory columns. When itemizing an order, you can find useful information in the various sublevel forms, such as order tracing, inventory for part, part availability, etc. Now let's return to the main form and change the status to one that will allow ordered goods to be shipped to the customer. Now we can go to the direct activations and print the order confirmation. Additional information regarding orders can be found in the sales orders wizards.